Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about upgrading your SCCM to 1906. Most likely, you might not have the package available, so you might have to push it to yourself so you can start playing around with it, right? Like an early upgrade. Looks like Microsoft is getting really strict with the requirements. To get 1906, you got to make sure that you're running at least 1903, Server 2012 plus. And for the database, you got to make sure it's running 2008 R2 plus. Okay. So on my desktop, I'm going to right click on the start menu, click on run, type in WinVER, and then hit okay. I'm running Server 2016 for my environment. And I believe for my database, I'm running 2014. So I should be good to go. Now, what we need to do is download the early build for 1906. This is a PowerShell that will allow you to get the package early within your configuration manager. So this is the link, and I will provide the link for you guys at the description or at the comment section, so don't freak out. But once you copy and paste it into your favorite browser, hit enter, and it should start downloading. Because I'm using Internet Explorer within my server, I need to click on the little arrow, and I'm gonna go save as, and I'm gonna drop it inside my desktop and then click save. And we're gonna close that browser up. So now we have the enable early upgrade ring for 1906 for our SCCM. So once you have your file, you locate it. Most likely you dropped it inside your downloads folder. Find it, right click on it, run it as an administrator. And from here, it's gonna drop it inside the desktop. It's a PowerShell, that's it. Click okay, and click okay again, and you're done. PowerShell is right there. So I'm going to basically click on start, and I'm going to locate Windows PowerShell ISE. I'm gonna right click on it, go to more, and I'm gonna run it as an administrator. But I'm gonna open up this particular enabled early upgrade ring 1906 PowerShell script within the PowerShell ISE console, and I'm just gonna run it, right? I believe it's F5 to run it. And it's gonna want you to enter your site server. Now I use the full qualified domain name of my SCCM server, hit enter. And if everything goes well, you should get the command completed successfully. Great. If you have any issues, you gotta make sure you're running it as an administrator. Now open up your SCCM console, and you wanna go inside administration, overview, updates and servicing, and you should see the configuration manager 1906 package. Underneath the state column, it should say available to download. Now, for me, I was like, I want to download it. I want to download it. So I right clicked on it. I clicked on download, and it was like, checking for updates. You could click refresh to update the console. Behind the scenes, it was still updating itself or downloading itself. So it takes some time. You are able to refresh the console, and eventually the state column is going to say ready to install. Now, from here, I'm going to right click on it and click on install update pack. Now, you could do run prerequisite check, but when you do the install update pack, it's going to do it for you regardless. So I picked the first option, install the update pack. You get the nice little wizard. I did not check ignore. All right, I left it as is, clicked on next. These are all the new features that this particular update is going to provide for your SCCM console. A lot of cool things. I need to actually take some time to see what they're going to do and probably do future videos for you guys. I don't know. Click next here. I'm definitely gonna do upgrade without validating. Click next, accept the license and terms, click next again, a nice little summary, and then click next. It's gonna start doing its magic, and if everything goes well, you should get the green check mark. Awesome. And close the wizard. And then underneath the state column, it should start saying installing. If you want, you could go at the lower right hand side where it says related objects and click on show status. And it's gonna take you here, and you're gonna right click and show the status, and you should see a nice little bird's eye view of what's happening behind the scenes with the latest package, which is SCCM 1906, all right? And then eventually your state will change to installing to checking prerequisites, and then again, it's going to change again to installing. And if everything works well, if you walk away, like I typically like constantly click on refresh until I get a dialog box. But when I came back from lunch, I got this nice little kind of tab kind of thing at the top. It says, a new version of the console is available, blah, 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 blah. Click on the install the new console version. So that's what I did. I clicked on it. Your entire SCCM console will close, so do not freak out. Eventually, something's going to pop up, but for me, this always happens. For me, I actually have to right-click on the taskbar, click on Task Manager, locate the Microsoft Configuration Manager, select it, right-click on it, and end the task. And then I do a retry. When I do the retry, then it's going to start downloading the files. That's a good sign. And then this process took a while. I started preparing the install. I started removing the old application to install the new one. And eventually, if everything works well, your SCCM console should load up, right? Now, the way that you could check if everything was upgraded is on the upper left side, like the little menu, little sub menu, click on it and go to About Configuration Manager, and you should see version 1906 with the console version and the site version. Cool. Another way you could check is go back inside Administration, Overview, Updates and Servicing, and you will see that the new update did a little cleanup, and you will only see your Configuration Manager 1906, and underneath the state column is going to say Install. How awesome is that? So hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. I will leave all the links that you need, such as the PowerShell script. And for those individuals that did not upgrade the ADK, make sure you upgrade your ADK. I think the latest right now that Microsoft has is ADK 1903. Eventually, they're going to be pushing out 1906. So make sure you got that stuff upgraded behind the scenes. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Leave comments right below. Don't forget about hitting that like button, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.